हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम अगेन टू दिस चैनल एंड वी आर कंटिन्यूइंग विद आवर सेशन ऑन फंडामेंटल कॉन्सेप्ट्स ऑफ आईसी 61850। इन लास्ट टू सेशन वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड व्हाट आर द सम ऑफ द बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट्स रिलेटेड विद 61850, हाउ 61850 आर यूजफुल फॉर सबस्टेशन ऑटोमेशन, व्हाट आर द प्रोविजंस ऑफ 61850 एप्लीकेबल फॉर सबस्टेशन ऑटोमेशंस। वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द रिपोर्टिंग एंड goose configuration, basically the basic concepts of goose. In this session we are going to discuss about the SCL language. So without wasting any time, let us start with today's topic, which is IEC 61850 SCL language. So the IED and substations are described through XML files, and the language used in these XML files in 61850 is called SCL language. Basically SCL is substation configuration language, as you can see over here, which is open in Notepad. This is the basic structure of the SCL language XML files of 61850. I am going to discuss about this SCL language in greater details in the coming slides. Basically, all the devices and the protection functions in 61850 are described through some logical nodes, and these logical nodes are then mapped for the substation automations in 61850. If you see, this is the same single line diagram which I have considered during the first and the second session. This is a two bus system. In this two bus system, suppose this is your bus 1, this is bus 2, then you have three feeders, and these are isolators, breakers, then CT, like that, for one feeder, second feeder and third feeder. Now if you see the first feeder, in the first feeder you will be having one IED. IED means intelligent electronic device, and this IED can be your BCU or protective relays, anything can be IED. So now suppose this is one IED, and in this IED, what are the basic logical nodes that you must have? So in order to represent this complete feeder, what you need? You need two isolators, one breaker, and then their associated interlocks and some protection functions as well. So if you see over here, this XCBR, this logical node is for breaker. So XCBR, this is for breaker, and I am going to discuss about this in greater detail in some separate session where I will discuss in details about the IEC 61850. Since this is in this series, I am discussing only the fundamental concepts, that's why I am not going in greater details about these things. Then CSWI, this is for the control. C means control, and SWI is for switch, and the switch may be your isolator or a switch. So if you see somewhere like CSWIA, that means this is the control switch A, and for better representation it may be represented as CSWI89A. So like this, the SCL language or the XML files are then created. Next, this CILO. So again, C is for control and ILO is for interlock. So all logical nodes are already available in your 61850. Then this any node which starts with P, actually any node which starts with P related to protection. So now you can have protection distance, protection overcurrent, and this overcurrent can be your time delayed overcurrent or instantaneous overcurrent. So these are the logical nodes: protection time delayed overcurrent, protection in inverse overcurrent, protection distance. Then you will be having some protection related functions, and these protection related functions basically are, suppose, auto reclose. So auto reclose is not a protection function in itself, but it is a protection related function. So all protection related functions logical nodes start with R. So R, if there is any logical node starts with R, it is basically for protection related function. And the protection related functions may be your REC, that is auto reclose, R BRF, that is your breaker failure. So this is for IED 1. Similarly, you will be having for IED 2, and finally for ID 3. So in every ID you will be having some control functions and some protection function. You may be having some measurement values also, like MMXU, MMXI. So these things that you will be also having in your IDs. So now if you see this, how the modeling is done, this is basically a screenshot of your PCM software of ABB relay. And in the PCM software, if you see this application configuration, then in the application configuration, this is basically in the IET configuration tools. So this IET configuration tool is basically the IED configuration tools of ABB software. And this IET configuration tool is basically used for configuration of 61850 in ABB relays. If you see over here, this is for REL670 relay, and this REL670 is basically your IED name. And what is the name of this IED? REL670 IEC. Inside this REL, if you expand, the first thing that you see over here is LD0. LD0 is for logical device. Then if you expand this LD0, there will be many logical nodes, and in that many logical nodes, suppose this is SMPTRC1, and P, as I have already explained to you, P is for protection and TRC is for trip. So SMPTRC is basically, if you see here, SMPTRC, this is for trip circuit breaker. Then in the SMPTRC, this SMPTRC is basically called logical nodes, and this is for trip function. And if you expand this SMPTRC, then you will see over here as OP. OP is basically operate, and this is your data object. So OP, or you may be having another thing which is STR. STR is also a data object, or you may be having behavior or health. So these are the data objects. Then if you expand OP, you will get general trip, A phase, B phase or C phase trip, and these are called data attributes. So in a nutshell, if you say this is your logical, or this is suppose your physical device. So if this is your REL670, which is physical device, or 7SA522, which is your physical device, then in this device there are some logical devices for 61850, and this out of the those many devices, suppose one device is your LD0. Now in this LD0 there will be having many logical nodes. These are logical nodes, and out of those many logical nodes, suppose I am considering only one logical nodes. This is your SMPTRC, PTRC, or PDIS. Now, in this logical nodes, this is logical nodes. Inside this logical nodes, you will be having some data objects, and inside data object, you will be having data attributes. So, this is the basic structure. Physical device. Inside the physical device, you will be having logical device. Inside the logical device, you will be having logical nodes. Inside the logical nodes, you will be having data objects. And finally, data objects will be having data attributes. So this is your data attributes, data objects, logical node, logical device, and finally the physical device. So if you see over here, this is the SCL language, IED modeling, PTRC. So if you see, this is the PTRC block, and this PTRC block, this is for feeder 1 or bay 1. And now this is the PCM application configuration. I am not going into the greater details of this block. I will discuss about these things when we will discuss the PCM software. So in the fundamental concept session, this is not required for present discussion. So now if you see over here, this is PTRC, which is the protection trip general. And if you see this PTRC block, this will be the same for every relay. So if you are having REL670 or RET670 or 7SA522 or 7SJ60 or P444, the PTRC block will be same. Only difference is how these PTRC blocks are represented in any manufactured relay. So if this is ABB relay, suppose your PTRC block is represented like this, and then you will be having general trip, R phase, Y phase, B phase. In Siemens relay, you may be having relay trip, then you will be having trip phase A, trip phase B, trip phase C. And if you extend there, then the logical nodes will be PTRC, PTRC, PTRC. This is the logical nodes. Then after that, you will be having that object, which is OP. PTRCOP, and then the data objects, which is phase A, phase B, phase C, like this. So this is the same example. Now for 7HA64, if you expand, this is the 7HA64, which is the physical device. Now this physical device, this is your logical device LD0. Inside this logical device, there are many logical nodes. If you expand this SMPTRC, which is your logical node for general trip, then you will get these signals. So now if you go to REL670, again same, this is your logical device. Inside this logical device, this is your logical node SMPTRC. In this SMPTRC logical node, this is your data objects, and this data objects is basically operate. And now if you see this data attributes, general, phase A, phase B, phase C, and which are these signals, trip, trip L1, trip L2, trip L3. And if you configure your ID, if you configure your relay correctly using the 61850 standard, then any engineer or any other person who are working on your SCL file, they will instantaneously after seeing these files, they will infer that what are the information contained in your SCL files. Suppose your SCL file contains PTRCOPA, so immediately on seeing this, they will conclude that, oh, this is for protection trip and this is general trip for phase A. Now so this is the same thing. Bay 1, PTRC is for trip or operate. So through this, I am going to explain you that you cannot open all the relays. You cannot, because if you want to open all the relays, you must have the software of all the relays. For example, for Siemens Dixie software or ABB PCM software or S1 Agile of your MICOM, or for your software for your D60 relay. But if you know the SCL language, then you can conclude that what are the information hidden inside your SCL files. For example, if you know this is PTRC, and if your PTRC, then it contains only trip general, then you can directly infer that this is for three-phase trip. Now, this is the same thing which I have already explained. This is a physical device. Suppose this can be your REL670 or 7SA522 or P444. In this physical device, there are many logical devices, and out of those many logical devices, suppose one of the logical devices is your LD0. So this is your LD0 logical device. Now all logical devices will have many logical nodes. So these are your logical nodes, and out of many logical nodes, suppose one of the logical nodes is your PDIS or PTOC or PIOC, then all these logical nodes, they will be having some data objects, and all those data objects will be having some data attributes. So it is possible to structure the logical nodes and group them under different logical devices. The rule of this structure are described in XML file. So now the services IoT modeling. If you see, these are the two examples of your SCL files, and if you see the first file, it is only a portion of the files. It basically starts with services, and in that services, what it basically says that it has a configured data set of maximum 21 data sets with report control of maximum 12 and the maximum goose control block of 8. So then it ends. So whenever you see this symbol, it can say that this program ends here. So this ends here. So this services, which starts from here, it will end at this point, and whatever is written inside this, it will be the informations of your SCL file. Now if you see this, there are almost same thing up to this point. The only difference is it also contains file handling, and now this file handling can be for your DR uploading, or suppose some DR related functions. So this is mentioned over here. This ID allows to upload the disturbance recorder files. File handling services listed. So because here file handling services listed. So now there are many types of SCL files depending upon the information that they carry, and some of the most important SCL files are ICD. ICD is basically your IED capability description. IED is again intelligent electronic devices, which can be your BCU, relay, online DGA devices, online ODS or online drive system. So this is your ICD files. which is IED capability description, then CID, which is configured IED description, SCD, which is substation configuration description, SSD, which is substation specification description. These all were in the edition 1 of 61850. So this is in the edition 1 of 61850, that is 61850-8-1 part 1. Then in the second edition, there are two additional files. One is IID, that is instantiated IED description, and second is SED, that is system exchange description. I will discuss in details about this file in the coming slides. So now up to this point, I have discussed about these things. Control interlocking, I have covered in the first session, horizontal communication, then protection schemes and horizontal communication in the first session itself. Then the SCADA vertical communications, network topology, and some form of the horizontal communication, that is GOOS, I have discussed in the second session. Then ICD, SCL files, etc., I am going to discuss in this session. So now, the engineering process. How this engineering IEC 61850 engineering is done basically. So an IEC 61850 substation is described by one special SCL file called SCD files, that is substation configuration description, and I will discuss in details in the coming slides. First of all, there are software tools that can extract engineering information from the SCD files and represent them in a comfortable way to the user. So an SCD files, which is basically an XML file. And if you want to extract information from those XML files, you need some software tools. And generally, the software tools are either from the relay manufacturer or the third party like Omicron IEDS Code. So now the engineering process in the first or the second session, I have discussed about the concept of horizontal communication, wherein we have discussed about GOOS. In this session, I am going to discuss the concept of vertical communication, which is basically for reporting. And all 61850 devices describe themselves with the help of SCL language. This I have already explained. SCL information from all IDs are integrated into the 61850 engineering tools. This also I have discussed. What is the meaning of vertical communication? Basically, the meaning of vertical communication is, this is suppose your HMI, or this is suppose your SCADA PC. You want the information, or you want to control the circuit breakers or isolator from this PC, or you want the status of isolators, breakers, etc., or the event logs, then all these information you required over here, but these informations are contained in these IDs over here in your SPR or in the kiosk. So once this IED report this signal to the HMI PC or to the gateway, through some mechanism, and those communications are called your vertical communications and reporting. So I will going to discuss about this in the coming slide. So what is the meaning of vertical communication? A SCADA system is also 61850 compliant, and it can read the SCD files, understanding how the substation look like. This is very simple thing. Which IDs are present and which information they send to the SCADA system, this I have already explained. If you see over here, so again, this is a 7AJ66 relay. This is having many logical devices, suppose PROT, MEAS, DR, CTRL. And now if you go inside this logical node, there are many logical nodes. And if you go to any logical node, suppose CTRL, then you can see there are more behavior, health, etc. And the important thing over here is the data sets or the report control blocks, which are created. Basically, if you see here, this URCB is for report control blocks, and U is basically for unbuffered. So you can be having two types of reporting, buffered and unbuffered. And what are the meaning of this report control blocks? Suppose you want to send some signals like the status of your isolators or circuit breaker, status of CB isolators, earth switch, etc. So you can create one data set containing these status. You can create some other data sets, suppose which contain some single point status signals or single point events like your spring charge, DC unhealthy, or AC supply fail, DC12 faulty. So these are another data set. Then you can create one more data set, suppose the protection data set, which can contains the information like PDIS 1 OP, PDIS 2 OP, PDIS 3 OP, then PTOC, etc. So then you will be having many data sets, and you can send each data set through one report control block to the SCADA PC. And this is what it looks like once you have created this suppose three data set, data set 1, data set 2, data set 3, containing many information or many signals. Then you have created two or three report control blocks. Suppose this report control blocks JLH. Now in the first report control block, this is the ID which comes by default. Suppose the data set that I have configured is data set 1. So now this report control block, it will set the data set 1 to your SCADA PC. Now Goose is basically the horizontal communication. I have already explained about the Goose in the first session itself. The only important thing about Goose is that in the Goose also you have to create some Goose control block. Like if you see here, these are your report control block up to this point. These are report control blocks, and then you are having Goose control block. These three are Goose control blocks, and if you go to the properties of any of the Goose control block, the important thing over here is some of the things which are very important is the maximum time, that is the time when there are no change in the status of the signal and the signal is being repeated. Suppose the breaker is in the closed position, so the closed position will be keep the ID will keep on sending this closed position after every 5 seconds. This is the maximum time, and the minimum time is suppose the 4 milliseconds. So now in every 4 milliseconds, whenever there is a status change, it will keep on repeating the signal. VLAN priority is basically the virtual LAN priority, and this virtual LAN priority, it comes for the Goose because in the Goose signals you must have the highest priority when sending the Goose signals. Then the application ID, this application ID must be unique for each Goose control blocks. So if you see the in the SCL files, there is written which ID talks to which ID, and this is written through your Goose control blocks. And in the Goose control blocks, how you interlinks two signals, that defines which ID talks to which ID through MAC addresses. The standard message among ID in the same substation are called Goose message. I already explained in the last session, Goose is for generic object oriented substation event. Goose message can contain protection application information, that is trip, block, etc. Then comes the 61850 engineering tools. So one 61850 engineering tool is in principle a software that handles SCL files. So any software that handles SCL file is a 61850 engineering tools. The initial SCL files which are provided by IED vendor software tools, they are called ICD files. So suppose you are having a 77SA522 relay and you are using Dixie software. So the initial SCL file which you export using the Dixie, that is called ICD, which is IED capability description file. This IED capability description file contains all the available logical nodes, all the available logical devices of your 7SA522 device, 7SA522 relay. And this is raw files. This contains many informations, and you have to choose out of those information what you need in your substation automation system. So these ICD files are imported in the 61850 engineering tools, and Goose reporting information are added for each ID. If there are any Goose signal, then the reporting information are added. Then the files, after adding this Goose information, whatever files are created, this is called SCD, which is basically your substation configuration description files. Then these SCD files are exported from the engineering tools, and IED vendor tools will import that file and will download in the IED in 61850 information that are written in the SCD files. So once you are having this 7SA522 relay, you will create using Dixie the ICD file. This ICD file will be exported. Basically in the Dixie, you also have the feature for creating 61850 SCD files, but suppose you are using a third party engineering tool, so you will export this ICD file. Now this ICD file will be imported in one of the 6850 engineering tools. Then you insert all the Goose informations, RCB, etc. And then this SCD file is created. Once this SCD file is created, then it will be imported back to your Dixie. So you import this, and once it will import it, then you write to your relays, and this completes the process. Basically in Dixie, the ICD, SCD, everything is created inside the Dixie itself, because the Dixie contains your 61850 configurator in itself. So now This is the basic process. Suppose you are having four IED, IED A, IED B, IED C, IED D. So the, at the first level, the vendor specific tools, suppose Dixie or PCM or your S1 Agile. So these softwares, vendor specific tools, this will export SCL file. That SCL file is called ICD. So the ICD file of ID1, ICD file of IDB, ICD file of IDC, ICD file of IDD, and these all ICD files are then imported to your 61850 engineering tools. And when you combine all these ICD files, merge all these ICD files, create the data sets, goods send, goods receive, and the report control blocks, then your SCD will be created. So the SCD is basically a combination of ICD A plus ICD B plus ICD C along with your GCB, RCB, etc. So this completes your SCD files, and once you create this SCD files, so then you have to export the SCD files and then import the SCD files to all the vendor specific tools of ID1, ID2, ID3, ID4. Once you import these SCD files in the vendor specific tool, what you have to do next is you have to write this SCD file to your ID. And once you write, then you are ready to go. Your 61850 engineering process completes over here. So the documentation ICD file describes the substation in 61850 language, which, and the language is SCL, that is substation configuration language. The IEC 61850 tool is able to elaborate such information and to show it in human readable format like PDF file. So if you are having a 61850 tool, then you can read the information contained inside your SCL files easily. So this is one of the example where you are using the information, or you are getting the information contained in the SCL file in a PDF format using 61850 engineering tools. So now this completes one of the important portion, that is the tools or the processes of engineering. So again, one thing which is ICD is basically IED capability description. So all logical nodes, all logical device, everything will be in this ICD file, IED capability description. This important difference between ICD and CID. CID is basically your configured IED description. So configured IED description, if you see here, this is configured and this is capability. So this contains all the logical nodes, all the logical devices, but in the CID, only those logical nodes will be visible which you have configured. So some of the manufacturers, some of the or SCADA automation engineers, they use CID, some will use ICD for the creation of SCD. It is up to you. So now moving to the next topic, which is your process bus. As I have already explained the level, this is basically the four level. This is process level, then the bay level, substation level, and this is the remote level. So these are the four level that I have already explained in previous sessions. Process level, what you contains, what are the elements present here? These are CB, CT, isolator, earth switch, transformer, all the devices which are available in this substation or in the switch yards are at the process level. All the wirings are through the copper cable. Now from the process level to bay level, you are having IEDs. So these are IEDs, which can be your IEDs, which can be protection or control IEDs. All the wiring from the process to the bay level are through copper cables. This is in 61850-8-1. All the wiring are through the copper cables. Then the bay level itself, you are having some Ethernet switch for networking. This is Ethernet switch, LIU, everything. And then these are connected to your substation Ethernet switch. This is Ethernet switch. From here, you will be having gateway, SAS PC, GPS, everything. And this is your substation level. And the next level from this gateway to the remote level is your remote control center, RCC, or network control center, NCC. So in the 61850-8-1, all the wiring from the process level to the bay level is through copper cable. But if you remove this copper cable, and if you are having the optical CTs or non-conventional instrument transformers, CT or CVT over here, or you are You can directly use the optical cable for the connection of processed devices to the bay-level devices, then it falls under the category of 61850-9-2. And then this bus, which are available here, is then it is called process bus, and this is the latest technology, latest 61850 digital substation. This all falls under the process bus technology, digital substation, and I am going to explain this in this slide and in the next couple of slides. So the process bus, what you contains, there are some non-conventional instrument transformer, that is your, suppose the Faraday effect optical CTs or CVTs, then the merging units. Basically the merging units are used for to create the sampled value from your non-conventional or the conventional CTs, optical CTs. If you are having CTs and if you convert those electrical signal to the optical signals, and then those optical signals are merged into one unit, and this merging unit, it will give you the sampled stream of value, sampled stream of your analog values in the digital domain. Then the 61850-9-2, this I am going to discuss. Already I have discussed 9-2 is basically for the process level. Sampled value is for the analog data in the sampled format. So now if you see over here, this is the 8-1 in which you are having this station bus. Station bus, it is now here. You are having some HMI engineering pieces, and then router come firewalls for control center. Then the switches which are connected to the bay level devices through bay controller relay or ODS or DGA devices. But in the 9-2, what happens is then you are having the switch gears, that is breakers, isolators, everything. Then the CTs, CVTs, the merging devices, merging units, everything are connected through the fiber optic cable to your IEDs. So the copper cables has been removed from this end, and this is 9-2. So all up to here, which are in the green color, it was in the scope of 8-1. Remaining now these wires, this is under, falls under the purview of 9-2. For the time synchronization, now you need highest level of accuracy, and this is PPS for your 9-2. For 8-1, NTP were used, network time protocol. Now PPS, pulse per second, it is basically used. The highest level of accuracy, why? Because now you are using the digital streams for the analog value, that is sampled value signals, and if you miss any one or two signals, then there are chances of inaccuracy, chances of wrong operations. So now the relay, this is the basic microprocessor based relay, these CTs or CVTs, these are connected through the field wires, are connected to this CT or CVT of your IEDs. Then this analog values through the A to D conversion processes, these are converted to digital domains. Then you are having some binary input cards, some binary output cards. Inside this relay, you are having some processor blocks, which use, suppose this is protection time over delayed current, or time over time delayed over current. So now the current and voltage information, it will receive through this AYD conversion process. The binary input, and based upon this, either current or through the binary input, it will issue a trip command. One of the output gets activated and it will trip your circuit breaker. But what happens there, first of all, in the 8-1, I already explained the last session, you can remove your binary output and binary input cards. So if you remove these binary output cards, and in the next level, if you remove the binary input card also, this is the 8-1 station bus. In the 8-1 station bus, your CTs, CVTs, it is hardwired to the relay. Then the analog to digital converter, it converts this analog signal to the digital domain, and the relay will take the decision based upon the algorithm, based upon the configuration. And finally, through the Ethernet port, these goose signals are transferred to the next ID for the tripping purpose. But if you remove this CT, CVT analog to digital card also, then it will change from 8-1 to 9-2 IED. So what happens now? Replacement of analog cards plus A by D conversion. And this is the next level in which I have removed everything, and this is 9-2. And how we can get this removal of CT, CVT card. So now you need the sampled value signal, sampled value of analog signals, and this sampled value you can get either through the non-conventional instrument transformer, suppose optical CT, which is capable of giving you these signals in a sampled value domain, or you can use a merging units, and you can connect your conventional CTs to the merging units, and from the merging units you will get the sampled value. The important thing over here is this Ethernet port. This Ethernet port must be 9-2 compliant. Then the another thing, for the 8-1, the network topology that we are using were either ring or a star, but in case of 9-2, this topology changes to PRP or HSN. And I'm not going to give you the detailed description of PRP or HSN in this session. We will discuss definitely this during the coming sessions on substation automation. Basically, PRP is for parallel redundancy protocol. Parallel redundancy protocol. Then the HSN is basically highly seamless redundancy protocol, HSN or HSR, highly seamless redundancy protocol. And this we will discuss in some separate session. So now, this is the, what are the sampled value? So this is your CT or CVT. Now you are having this current values or voltage. These are going to the merging units, and the merging units, then it will, through synchronization, monitoring and test configuration, it will give you the sampled values. So if conventional CTs and CVTs are used, then your analog input transformers, analog measurement, analog to digital conversions, all these things are moved away from the IDs, because in the 8-1, what we are doing is we are using the hard wiring, this is the copper cable, up to your IED level. And in the IED, since you are using the copper cable for the analog current and voltages, what it does basically is converts this analog signal to digital signal through A by D conversion. And all these are measured in the analog domain. But in the 9-2, these things are moved away from IED and placed into a separate black box or device that is called merging unit. So this is a merging unit. So now, instead of connecting your current and voltage channels to the IED, it is connected to merging units, and the merging units will give your sampled value stream to the IED. If non-conventional CTs or VTs are used, so new measurement techniques like Faraday effect CT, so the probably positive impact on new numerical protection algorithm, because now you will get the sampled value directly from the instrument transformer to the IEDs. So another thing is that the accuracy of merging unit decides the performance of your IED in 61850-9-2. Basically, the transient performance of merging units are not yet defined. It is still under study. This means that the same primary current and voltage may result in different secondary streams from different merging units. Further, the transient performance of merging units have an impact on numerical protection algorithm for the relay manufacturer. So this completes our 9-2 process bus. Hopefully, whatever is explained in last three sessions, including this one, is clear to you. We will definitely discuss in greater details about 61850 in the coming sessions. And once we complete in details about the 61850 standard, then we will move to your SCADA configuration through some of the software. Or primarily, I will discuss about the Siemens SCADA configuration and then Schneider or GE SCADA configuration. Once you understand these concepts of 61850 engineering, then these things will be very easy for you. I hope whatever concepts are explained in last three sessions, including this one, is clear to you. If you like this video, then please share the content with other fellow engineers, so that they may also learn from this video. They may also get benefited. Also, if you didn't like the content, then you may comment in the comment section, so that based upon the feedback received from your side, I will try to improve from our next session onwards. Thank you for watching. Keep learning. We will meet again with some new topics in the coming sessions or in the coming days. Till then, thank you and goodbye.